With, I think so. Most of you will be aware with what is internet banking, and we will discuss with the history how internet banking started, how long ago it was started, and what services internet banking in today's scenario is providing, and how many problems basically of the society of societies, what value-added services internet banking is providing today, and how we are using it. And what will be the how the life is easy with internet banking, right? And that we will discuss in today's topic, and how it can be used in the business scenario, and if you are a digit as a digital marketer, how we can use in as a e-commerce expert, how we can use that, how you can use that, and right, and a lot of things, payment gateways and all we have discussed in digital marketing as well. And we will also discuss again these things in some detail in this syllabus as well, right? So today's topic is internet banking. Internet banking is today's topic, and I will start with the history. And online services started in New York in 1981 when four of the city major banks. Online services means the scenario was entirely different when they started by the Citibank, says Manhattan, and chemical manufacturers Hanover, right? And we normally start uploading websites and all in around 1991 after invent of HTML and all. And the time that we are talking about online services, where the scenario was quite different at that time, right? And that was offered home banking, basically services using video, basically calling and all. It was basically more or type of a phone banking services, right? And internet banking allows you to conduct bank transactions online instead of finding a bank and interacting with a teller. Today, your parents are transferring money to you, and most of them are not visiting bank for transfer the money, and hardly sometimes they may be going and depositing money on your direct account, and rest of the time they may be transferring from their mobile device or using their desktops, right? And even today, we are aware with that wallets, e-wallets, and they made the life more easy, like Google Pay, and one can transfer money from one account if you have linked your account with your UPI payment system, and your mobile number, your cell number is linked with your bank account, then you can receive or you can transfer money to anyone using the similar services, and that is again more easy, and no need to enter account detail, that is IFSC code. We need a account number to transfer money. Minimum two things are required: account number of to whom you are going to pay, and IFSC code of the branch. Suppose your account is with SBI or PNB or Axis Bank, right? So each bank has an individual IFSC code that we need to transfer money, account number and IFSC code. And account number generally have 11 to 16 digit. Like SBI is using 11-digit account numbers, and other mostly the banks are using 16 digits account numbers, right? Account numbers. So for internet banking, we need account number and IFSC code. Even we don't need the name of the pay. Don't need even the name. We need basically account number and IFSC code for internet transactions, right? And if you are using mobile wallets like Paytm and Google Pay are different. Google Pay is for not holding that. It's not basically having a mobile wallet, I think. Wallets where we can keep money. We basically transfer money directly from one account to another by using mobile number, which is connected with that account number of a particular bank. Internet banking allows you to conduct bank transactions online instead of finding a bank and interacting with a teller. The machines are making life simpler and simpler. Initially, we have ATM machines. We have ATM machines, and we can withdraw our money using ATM card. Now we can even deposit in machine as well. So we can deposit money on a machine by using our account number, right? You can by using our account number, right? Or card as well. So we don't have to interact with any human being for depositing and withdrawing the money, for transferring the money. Even with most of the services for applying for a checkbook, everything, these services we can manage by internet banking or mobile banking. In a broad sense, it is the use of electronic means to transfer funds directly from one account to another rather than by check or cash. Instead of using check or cash. The internet banking is not only about transferring funds from one account to another account. Internet banking is more than that. Internet banking is you can apply for a demat account. You can open online with the help of the internet. If you are having the internet banking, you can open sitting at your home a fixed deposit account, a recurring deposit account, right? A dream deposit account. Different types of account within that you can open by the help of internet banking. You can apply for a credit card. You can apply for a personal loan. You can apply for a checkbook, right? And that will be delivered at your doorstep, at your home. So internet banking is not only about transferring home funds. You can or we can avail different banking services using internet that we will discuss. A system of banking in which customers can view their account details, if the account setting is only view, not transfer, that is, can view account details, pay bills. Even using that internet banking, you can pay your bills of electricity, bills of water, and any other bills, your LIC installments, right? And you can recharge your mobile phone and transfer money by means of internet. Basically using internet. The remote delivery of new and traditional banking products, as I said, FD, RD, dream deposits, right? And ordering a checkbook or applying for a credit card, these are the banking products, right? And services through electronic delivery channels. The remote delivery of new and additional banking products and services through electronic delivery channels. Types of banking is there's a PC banking, we can say PC and laptop as well, digital TV banking, text phone banking, and internet banking. These are the remote banking systems, basically remote banking systems, right? And the data is little old, and as it is saying that internet banking on a PC, desktop, laptop is 87%. Not everyone is using mobile app or mobile banking, and most of us are still well versed with the internet banking and using laptops for fund transfer and other services instead of mobile banking, right? Like I am using Punjab National Bank's internet banking services, but I have not switched yet to mobile banking. Even one of my friend is manager there. He said you can switch to mobile banking. It is more quite convenient than internet banking. Now they launched a new app from some days ago. And but I am using Access and HDFC's internet mobile banking services. Right? Mobile banking means what we are. But you cannot find if you are using HDFC's mobile banking. Only few facilities are there on mobile banking. If you want to go for the any FD account, you want to open a new fixed deposit account or a recurring deposit account, you have to go for internet banking. So still internet banking is more used by account holders instead of mobile banking. We are using mobile banking as well for fund transfer, that is easy, right? And phone banking, right? The percentage is differ now, right? This is not 87, this will be around 50%, we can say, and this will be nearby 50% more than 50% people are using smartphone banking as well. And services we are availing for using mobile banking or internet banking. We are saying internet banking, whether you are using mobile or desktop or laptop, right? It must be clear. Internet banking is using the, we are using the internet. We may be using internet on desktop, laptop or a mobile device. Services availing bill payments. Of course, we are paying bills of electricity. Everyone using banking services. You may be using your wallet, Paytm or other services to pay, or some are use some. It even reminds us. We don't have to look for a physical bill, a bill send a printed copy of the bill sent by the electricity departments. Because if you have linked your connection number, connection ID of electricity board, right, with your any internet banking or mobile banking account, it reminds you whenever your bill appears. It fetches, updates the information. Your new bill has arrived. You have to pay that. This happens in Google Pay as well, right? Google Pay or any wallet you're using, they also reminding us, they also updating us basically. Updates us and as well as reminds us you have to pay your this bill, right? And once we have to connect with that electricity departments or ID, right? And bill payments is one service all of we are using for. Credit card, mostly everyone is using. This is another service. Banking, so insurance, we are purchasing insurance online mostly nowadays. Customer services, if you are handling customer accounts, right? Corporate customer accounts, many of you will be having the finance. So you'll be handling customer accounts, then you can easily provide a lot of services to your customers, finance related services. Recharging your prepaid phone, recharging your D2S services, recharging your data, any other recharge, and online shopping, as of course, these are the services we are availing using the internet banking. And these all services, of course, are not possible online shopping without, if we talk about prepayments, and normally in India, online shopping is mostly focused up to the 70-80% on COD, cash on delivery basis, right? So these are the services we are availing using the internet banking. Who can use internet banking? Statement, access internet banking, obtain your user ID and passwords. So we have to avail internet banking or while banking, we use user ID. User ID is different from account number. It is different from your account number. It is a different ID. Every bank gives to each customer your user ID. It is different from your this user ID or customer ID is different from your account number, and it's again unique, right? So they provide user ID and link the account with your user ID. So you need your user ID and password. You have to create your password. And normally if you have an ATM, then you can go for internet banking or mobile banking, right? And that need to connect your ATM pin and all when we start the internet banking. And this is basically the system. And user, here is the user, and user is connected with SSL connection, secure service layer, socket layer, security system is there, internet and security system. Then web server, we all know about a server where bank has hosted their application, their mobile, their web application, website, it means simply in the simple words, web server. Internet front office system, then bank back office system, and we have branch office terminals as well, right? So this is basically the internet banking system, right? Application service providers, first step in setup process is making a plan. What are the services to be installed, right? Internet and what services bank could implement in-house. What services we could implement through ASPs out of house, who are technology partners. If you are a banker, then you need to know what services you can. Like State Bank of India has a large team of technical people, and they have a tech office in Hyderabad, I think. And this may be with every bank or may not be. May not be their own employees are working on technology, working on, right? And they may be hiring for the most of the technology developments to from another companies, the large companies. Advantages, cost is less in internet banking, transactions, cost is less. This is for the bank as well as for the user. Because large number of accounts holds by the banks, if they are not providing internet banking services, then definitely they have to recruit around 4, 5, 6 people only for the withdrawal of money. Similarly for deposit of the money, right? The cost is quite less with the help of internet banking. Nobody is going to the on the bank for withdrawal, only few in emergency by having a check, right? Cost is less, transaction speed, high transaction fees, high efficiency in the business, speed banking and vast coverage. We can cover large number of base, client base. Issues and internet banking, security is an issue. In case of internet banking, learning difficulties, security, that is prime. We are talking from the first day. If we are talking about the e-commerce, we are talking about the security, right? Because the data is very vulnerable, and and hackers can try to get your account numbers, your account details as well, right? And a lot of different ways they are today even we hear from our friends and relatives that somebody called me for demanding such information. Initially they said that this amount will be deposited in an account, you please, right? And different ways now, if you are using that Google Pay, please use that cautiously, right? People are ready to steal your money from your accounts, right? Learning difficulties. Initially, it was tough for account holders to learn how to go for internet banking or mobile banking. It is not easy for everyone to understand, and not everyone is using internet banking still, because you need computer literacy and internet literacy to operate internet banking. Most of, maybe some of your parents may even not be using internet banking or mobile banking. They may be not confident about security. They may be not this much of internet literacy. They don't have this much of internet literacy. Maybe some of, right? And because learning difficulties, everyone is not very confident about. Lack of skilled personnel with the bank. Technical breakdowns. Technical breakdowns is a major issue. Even if you are inside a bank, right, and you want to deposit money, and if their server is down, then you will even not able to deposit the money. If you own a local account on that bank, they may keep your cash and will say that it will be updated in some cases. It will be updated when the server will be up, the services will be up, right? That is, the technical breakdown is a major issue. Major issue means if this happens anytime, once in a month even, or once in a week even, then it breaks the whole system, right? No services can be availed. You cannot transfer, you cannot, as I said, you cannot even deposit money. Deposit is the simplest way. You are going to deposit, not the withdrawal even. If services are down, then we cannot even deposit the money. The technology is a major issue, and that can, the banks normally works hard to manage that. They have partnered with the top technology companies, whether the ISP, internet service provider, they have direct lines for that. And they partnered with Oracle and IBM. They are basically, and a TCS, they are facilitating that, their software. Mostly the banking banking software as developed by IBM, Oracle, or TCS, or large, right? Infosys, the major software developers, because security, data protection, lot of issues are there. Lot of issues are involved. And nowadays, nobody is keeping any manual record of transactions. Everything is online. Everything is on the software. The security is prime importance. Technology is prime important on this issue. Inexpensive, right? Security risk, increasing number of fraudulent websites, fake emails purporting to be sent from banks, use of Trojan horse programs to capture user IDs and password, right? Technology, we are upgrading our technology, banking technology, software used in the banking systems. They are highly upgraded and latest with the latest technology. But still, the hackers are quite smart and they are trying to steal the information, banking related information from, right? Security problems and all. And these are the, you can go through. How can I be certain that my personal information is not altered by online AWS developers when they enter into a secure transaction on the web? So we have discussed about the security issues and different types of attacks, right? Some attacks are passive, some are active attacks. So in case of passive attacks, the attacker is only watching it. What I have in my mobile phone or in my laptop, they are not trying to alter any information, right? So these are the issues, and the banks are handling them as such cautiously. The strategy for bank is to provide valued added services and products to the consumer utilizing internet extensively, right? Today, bonds and PPF account, these services are bankers also providing. You can, right? Shares, you can, demat account, you can open online demat account and you can work with the share market and all. You can purchase, selling and purchasing the shares, right? These are the services banking systems bankers also providing us. Insurance services, whether health insurance or life insurance or general insurance, mostly all the banks have partnership with the financial institutions and they are providing that insurance services as well, right? And the main aim of e-banking is to making transactions through online poses and make customers more benefit and convenient, make the life more convenient. You can operate your account from your home, or you can operate your account on the go using your mobile phone, using your smartphone, right? You can transfer money, you can order a checkbook, you can, if you can open a demat account and you can purchase and sale and purchase of shares, you can purchase bonds, right? So these are the facilities bankers are providing. These are the products banking financial institutions and banking systems are providing, right? So this is about online banking and this is some referential websites. Thank you very much for the day.